org. Now, wasting no time to get to our Good Things guest today, joining us is director Larissa Lamb and producer Baldwin Chiu, who worked together on the award-winning film Far East Deep South. It explores the seldom-told history of early Chinese immigrants living in the American South during the late 1800s to the mid-1900s. It is told through the eyes of a family who traveled from California all the way down to us here in Mississippi, specifically the Mississippi Delta, to find answers about their grandpa and past. So, welcome, guys.
Hi, great to be here.
Hey, how's it going?
We're calling in from California, so hello to everyone in Mississippi.
That's what I was going to say. You guys literally came and then went back, and now you're calling in, and I always get the times, the time zones are sort of weird, so it's lunchtime for you guys, right?
It's lunch.
Yes.
So what did you bring?
I'm on my afternoon cup of coffee, so we lunched 30 to a few hours ago, but I'm so happy you guys are joining us here on Good Things, because I'm super excited about this film. I watched the trailer. I've dug into it over at the website, and I just think it's a phenomenal story to be shared. So this is actually a personal journey for your family. So how did the whole road trip to Mississippi / turn it into a documentary get started?
Well, about 5 years ago, I took a trip with Baldwin and his family to go visit his grandfather's grave site in Cleveland, Mississippi. And we actually had no idea where it was. We just had a photo of it. And we just knew, like, well, let's just take a, you know, almost like a pilgrimage to give your respects to your ancestors. It's kind of a common thing within, you know, especially Chinese culture. And so we really just were wandering around and calling City Hall is what your brother did, right?
Right. My brother called City Hall just to try to find information about my grandfather and great-grandfather, who we found out was buried there. So that's all we really had until we found the Chinese Mississippi, the museum in Mississippi.
The Mississippi Delta Chinese Heritage Museum at Delta State University. And that's kind of when we walked in and we were like, why is there a museum about Chinese in the middle of Mississippi? Because we're from California. There's obviously a lot of Asian population here. And we're both Chinese American, but I never knew that there was a lot of Chinese that lived in Mississippi, because we didn't learn about it in our history books or see it on TV. And so, like, I literally thought we were going to find two Chinese men buried in the cemetery in Mississippi.
That was it.
And we ended up uncovering this whole population with, you know, I'm sure many of your listeners and people are familiar with who are in Mississippi, but those of us outside of Mississippi are like, where did these people come from? And so that's why we ended up unlocking just these amazing family discoveries, but also the history that a lot of people don't know about the Mississippi and the Delta especially.
Well, I love that, because I think many of us listening to Good Things were either born and raised here in Mississippi. We understand roots are important. And I would say for me, when your film got sent my way, I was like, wow, they're right when it's talking about the seldom told history of early Chinese immigrants here to Mississippi. I mean, you would assume that maybe we had a melting pot of people in the Delta in the early days. We're talking about early days. But you're right. That story just doesn't get shared enough. I also didn't know until watching your trailer that there was a museum for Chinese Americans here in Mississippi. So what type of nuggets did you uncover as you were sort of going through your own personal journey about Chinese Americans here in Mississippi?
Well, one of the things that was most striking is we didn't realize that segregation also impacted the Chinese. You know, we were kind of taught in our schools, like, it's just a black and white issue. And so we had no idea that the Chinese were impacted. And, you know, upon further digging, especially with our new film, Far East Deep South, you know, we found out people that were Native Americans were also impacted by Jim Crow laws, people that were Mexican in other regions. And so it's something that we thought was, wow, we never felt a personal connection to that part of American history. And we're like, wow, our people were affected too.
Yeah, and I think it was also that when these different people groups were in the region, they weren't just there for a little while and not really doing anything for the community. All the contributions of the early Chinese as well as some of the other groups were significant, and you can see that it's still a part of the culture today. Like one of the things that we loved about Mississippi was deep-fried tamales, and we're like, where did these deep-fried tamales come from? And they're like, oh, yeah, the early Mexicans brought them over, and then we just decided to deep-fry them.
Yeah, because I think when people think of, you know, the South, they think of slavery, they think of segregation, they think of plantations, but then nobody ever thinks about, like, well, what happened after slavery was abolished? You know, sure, the, a lot of the African-American community became sharecroppers, but they, a lot of people left, and so they needed more labor, so where did they get the labor? They got it from China after the railroads. They had, hey, they were great workers, let's get them into work on the plantations, and then later on, they, you know, they started recruiting Mexican migrant workers, too. I mean, our story is focused, obviously, on the Chinese aspect of it, but these things you don't think about, but you're like, oh, yeah, that's right. You know?
Well, yeah, and it also helps us better understand our culture as well, because I think we're much more of a melting pot than we ever give ourselves, you know, sort of credit for. Some of it's just because you have these seldom told stories, which I think brings to light so many wonderful parts of our history, as well as wonderful parts of things we enjoy now in Mississippi's culture that we need to thank the Chinese Americans for, or maybe, you know, the Mexican Americans for coming over and sort of bringing us, particularly through the Delta. Now, Baldwin, I know it was your dad and your grandpa, right, that sort of brought you on the hunt to Mississippi. Did you get a chance, and I know you did because I saw the trailer, but did you get a chance to meet people there that knew your grandpa or had connections to your family here in Mississippi?
Yeah, even more so. We found some people that were really older, a lot older, that actually knew my great-grandfather. So, we met people that knew my great-grandfather and my grandfather, and obviously none of them actually knew my father, because my father, as people will see in the film, my father was never in Mississippi, and it was he actually grew up without a father, so I never had a grandfather. And so when we made this discovery in Mississippi, we literally thought we wouldn't find anything except maybe the gravestone. And then all of a sudden, when the Chinese Heritage Museum connected us with all these people, people came out of the woodworks. They're like, we know your family. We were wondering where your family came from, you know, where they went, you know, after they died. We just didn't know what happened. And my great-grandmother had left, and she never returned back to Mississippi. And my dad, you know, never really talked about it. So everyone in Mississippi that knew my family were wondering what happened to us until we showed up.
And that's kind of what our film, you know, Forest Deep South does, is take people through that journey of what our family experienced in this discovery, because we discovered these artifacts, people connected, in addition to the history. And it was just kind of a beautiful, amazing thing, things that we had never could have imagined we would have uncovered and discovered.
So which one of you decided, hey, this needs to be documented and turned into a film versus just, hey, let's pay respects and go find your family history. Now it's like, we have something special here. Let's collect everything we're learning and share this story.
Yeah, so my original thought was, this is just for our family. We're going to make a home video just so that my daughter can know her American history, so she could know where her lineage came from and to know how American she really is. And throughout that process, I told Larissa, who actually, you know, I don't know if you knew, but we're actually married. I told Larissa, just watch our daughter.
I was the babysitter. I was he was like, get out of our way. Let's just let us do our own thing, and you just stay out of the way. But what happened is, and without spoiling too much for people if they watch the movie, once we got to the museum at Delta State, and we walked in there, and then we find a very important family artifact. I was like, what is going on? I said, what is happening here? I said, I discovered this incredible history that we never learned about that I feel like everybody should learn about. Because, you know, one of the things for the Asian community, especially in America, is we're constantly perceived as kind of the perpetual foreigner. You look at someone Asian, you kind of default by thinking, oh, they must be from China, or they must be from, like, Korea or Asia. As opposed to if you look at somebody white or black, you automatically think, oh, they're from America. You don't think they're from, you know, the Ukraine or from Zimbabwe. You know, like, so there's this bias that we kind of have to fight all the time that a lot of people aren't aware of. And so for us to learn all this and this history, and that the fact that we don't learn this and most people don't think of us as very American, you know, that really changed my perspective, learning about the Chinese and the American South. So I really wanted to make this movie to share that, but just also the incredible discoveries that we had.
Well, you've got us so tickled to watch the movie Far East Deep South, and I know it's airing now, and you guys are going to have Q&A later tonight. So set us up. How can we watch it and tune in for you guys later on this afternoon?
Yeah, if you just go to the Oxford Film Festival website, you can purchase your tickets on their virtual site.
You can also go to our website, FareastDeepSouth.com. There are links to the film there, and the Q&A is going on, again, through the Oxford Film Festival website. We hope people will watch the film. It's only available until June 12th, but the Q&A is today,
tonight, yep.
At 7 p.m. Central.
Yes, 7 your time.
Well, if you're ever back in Mississippi, please come stop by the Good Things Studio. I would love to share some deep-fried tamales with you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I actually don't like tamales, but I love deep-fried tamales.
Thank you guys for your time. I appreciate you.
Thank you, Rebecca.
Thank you,